Hey everyone, I'm Adam Haritan. Right now I'm hanging out right next to one of my favorite wild vegetables, and this is Hesperis matronalis, Dame's Rocket. If you've never experienced the magic, the tastiness of Dame's Rocket, then pay attention, because this might turn into one of your favorite vegetables as well. So you can really find it this time of year because it's in flower, and so it's just popping up all along the sides of the roads in fields, and it really likes sunlight, so you'll see it there. This is a non-native plant, so it can handle some harvesting by human beings. You'll find it all over the eastern United States, primarily concentrated in the northeastern United States. And it is a cruciferous vegetable, kind of like kale or broccoli or Brussels sprouts. And so the entire plant is edible. And the part that I really like to harvest this time of year, one of my favorite things to eat out of any food out there, are these flowering buds before they even open. So I harvested two right here. You could see I harvested maybe just 5 inches down from the top of the panicle. And these flowers haven't opened yet. You can still eat it when the flowers are open. And what I like to do is put this in a frying pan and saute it with some butter and add some salt as well until it gets really crispy. It only takes maybe 4 or 5 minutes, and it is absolutely delicious. And of course, you can nibble on these raw, and they taste great as well. They're slightly bitter when you do eat them raw, but that bitterness almost goes completely away whenever you cook this in some kind of fat. So that's what I encourage you to do. Try that one out. Now, to properly identify this plant, as I said, it is in flower right now, so it's very easy to identify. It has 4 petaled flowers, like most wild mustards, and it's purplish or pinkish or whitish, some shade of those. And even on the same plant, you will see those different shades. Now, these leaves are alternately arranged, so they're staggered left and right, all up and down the stem. They're not opposite one another, and this entire plant can become a few feet high. Now, this plant, interestingly, has been studied for its medicinal properties. And in 2010, a paper was published showing that an aqueous extract from the stem, so a water extract from the stem, had powerful antibacterial properties, specifically against salmonella. Also, there are glucosinolates in this plant, and they're found throughout the cruciferous vegetable family. And these glucosinolates help to facilitate detoxification within our bodies. Specifically, what they do is help process and remove xenobiotics. So xenobiotics are foreign compounds or substances to our bodies, and these would be carcinogens, drugs, environmental pollutants, and other compounds. So it helps to process and remove those compounds from our bodies. Also, glucosinolates have been studied for their anti-tumor properties. But I think I'm most excited to be out here and just harvest this plant because I'm really excited to throw this in a frying pan and cook it up with a little bit of butter just for 4 or 5 minutes until it gets really crispy. Now, this plant won't be out there forever, so we only have a couple weeks to harvest this plant. But fortunately, there's enough of it out here right now. And as I said, it is non-native, so it can handle some harvesting by human beings. And if you've never experienced the magic of Dame's Rocket, Hesperis matronalis, perhaps when you do try it, it might just be one of your favorite wild vegetables that you didn't even know existed.